So this is the mass spring dumper system whose dynamics we are implementing and simulating in Simulink. It has an external force F of T. It has a spring and a damper that generate forces that oppose the external force. And the displacement of the system is represented by Y of T. So for the mathematical model we are implementing using the Newton's second law of motion, we know that the summation of the forces acting on the system is just mass times acceleration. And assuming that the external force is F of T, then the damping force and the spring force that are opposing the external force will be negative. So the damping force is just the damping coefficient times velocity, while the spring force is just the spring constant times the displacement. So substituting that, we'll have this equation. And now making the acceleration, which is Y dot dot the subject of the formula, we end up with this equation, which is the primary equation that we are implementing. And for the velocity, we integrate the acceleration over time to obtain the velocity. And for the position, we integrate the velocity over time to obtain it. So these are the set of equations that we are implementing. So our model parameters are defined here. Our mass is defined as 1 kg. We have our damping coefficient as 5 and spring constant as 2. So all the blocks we need can be found in library browser. So going to library browser. So I have the commonly used block here. I have the continuous block. I have mass operation. I have other sections. But all I need are within the commonly used block, the continuous block, and the mass operation. So if I just go to commonly used block, I need a constant. So I'll just bring out all the blocks that I need. I also need, I think, two gains for my implementation. So we are going to see how to connect them. I also need two integrators for integrating my acceleration and for integrating my velocity. I need a multiplexer for merging my signals. I also need a scope for visualizing my signal. And from the maths operation, I need my add block. So I think that is all I need for my implementation. So looking at the acceleration equation, I have three parts to add and or subtract. So it can be done using this add block. And I will change its name to Soma. And you can change the font if you want to make it bigger, for example, to 20, just to be bigger. So it has, by default, two signals intake. So I have to change the list of signs to positive, then I have negative, then I have the third one negative. So that will be reflected in the block. As you can see, it can take three signals now. The first signal it can take is the external force over mass. So my F over M, that is the first intake. So for the further two intakes, I need to first of all find my velocity and position. So let me just start with the output. So for the output, I know the output is just my acceleration. And I want to integrate the acceleration. So I will bring my integrator here. And then I will take it into the, so I can name the signal acceleration. So integrating the acceleration, I know that I will get a velocity, so I can also name it velocity. And I also want to integrate the velocity in order to obtain my position, which I want to visualize. So it is one of the things that I want to visualize. So I will just take it here. This is my position. I can name it here position. So I have my velocity and my position, which I needed in computing my acceleration. But they have to be multiplied by C over M and K over M. Flip this block using format, flip block, it will be flipped. I also need to flip this block, flip block, it will be flipped. So For the first one, I need my velocity times cm. So this one is just c over m. I can change it to 20. And this one is just k over m. So now I need to multiply c over m by velocity. So I just need to drag this signal here, and I also need my position, which is y times k over m. So I need to tap this signal. So the output here is just c over m times velocity, which is needed to be subtracted from f over m. So I just need to take this one to here, and this output here is just k over m times position. So I need to take this one from here to here. So as I said, this is just my complete model in Simulink. However, I'm using this multiplexer to combine the signals I want to visualize. First of all, I want to visualize my position. I also need to or want to visualize my velocity. So I will also tap this signal and then take it to the multiplexer. And then the two signals will be the output of this multiplexer. And then I will be taking it to my scope. You can give the initial value of your velocity using the first integrator. So I want the initial value to be zero. And I also can also give the initial value of my position using the second integrator. So I also want it to be zero. So here c over m, I know my m is just 1, so c over m will just be c, which is 5. I'll put my 5 within the gain if I double click into the gain. And for my k over m, it will just be 2 over 1, which is just 2. So this is my block diagram, and now all is set for simulation. So I can go to simulation, and for my force over m, it is also, if I want, for example, a force of 1, if I apply a force of 1 newton, 1 over 1 is just 1. So if I run this simulation for, say, 20 seconds, you can change the time. If you want 100 seconds or 5 seconds, you can change it from stop time. So if I run it, it is now done. If I click on my scope, I'll be able to see my position and velocity. So this is my position. As you can see, position is in blue from the legend here, and my velocity is in yellow. So as you can see, after I applied a force of 1 newton, it goes up to a position of 0.5 meters. As you can see, the velocity start increasing, and as it reaches the steady state value, it goes to zero. So we can actually change any parameter to see how it affects the system. So definitely we know that if we applied more force, the steady state value will increase. So for example, if we apply a force of 10 newtons, so we know that the settling position will be more than 0.5 meters now. So if we click on it again, we see now it goes up to 5 meters. We can also change other parameters. For example, the damping coefficient. We know that if we reduce the damping, the oscillation in the system will also increase. So you see now it becomes oscillatory. So you can change any parameter, the spring constant, to see how it affects the system. So you can set the simulation phase of your system using the simulation phase block. So if you click on the set phase block, you can put the simulation pause. For example, if I put 1 second, and if I run the simulation, now you'll be able to see how the system changes over time. can also hide all the components of your system such that you can only see the input and output. So if you highlight from input up to output, you then select create edge subsystem from selection, and you can see you have your system here, you have your input and you have your output. If you click on the subsystem, you'll be able to see the inner structure. Thank you for watching.